Hey guys, if you like the Dirt Block, consider becoming a member at humanechoes.com. Members get exclusive access to the awesome bonus podcast, a whole hour of comedy and wacky insight with Al, Joe, and Tony. Click the link in the description to find out more.
Yay!
Hey Joe, you're back!
I am back!
You survived.
Welcome back, Joe.
The internet has come back to me. Here's our build from last night. We might have gone overboard with the fire.
There was a lot of fire.
It was a little bit underwhelming fire-wise.
Underwhelming?
Yeah. You guys really should try harder for that.
Also dropping off stuff into boxes.
I mean, nobody died in lava, as far as I know.
I was whelmed.
Just regular whelmed.
Sometimes you just need a good whelming.
Is that pyramid so far?
Ah, no, I fell.
It is a real word, by the way. You can be whelmed.
It's kind of like how you can be gruntled.
Can you?
You're gruntled.
That I have not heard. I know there's a hymn lyric that talks about the whelming flood. Overwhelming is actually redundant. It's still... whelming means to be covered.
Yes.
By the way,
in like 33 BC?
Yeah.
It's possible the language has evolved a bit.
I'm standing in front of our towers of subscribers.
Oh, yes.
Thank you guys for helping us finish a new tower.
Yeah, and we're well
over
into the
600.
Second or the sixth one.
Yeah, I haven't even laid that out. There's only like three on the seventh tower so far, even though it's like 20-some beyond that. So thank you guys for hitting that subscribe button.
A lot of people in from Dwarf Fortress.
I had something
They're
I was going to say.
They're all here for the legend of the dirt block.
I was going to riff on. I can't remember what it was. What were we talking about before we started recording? Outside of recording stuff?
Funnels.
Was it my underwear?
God, no.
You'd think maybe we would come up with better content for our paying subscribers.
You'd think. I kept trying
I think John Jones described that as a sweaty business meeting.
Yes.
Basically what that podcast was.
Pretty much. I did mean to ask you, though, Albert. Did anyone tweet you privately
to discuss junk? Nobody did discuss the junk and like how it works out with their underwear. People just don't want to talk about it. So
yes.
Continue to soldier on in like complete ignorance. I don't know what works. I don't know why it works for other people and doesn't work for me.
Drugs.
Maybe I'm the only one. I just have to go on assuming that I'm weird. That's the human condition. You can't ask people questions about this stuff because they think you're weird.
I'd love to see you have this ambition for data with our numbers. That'd be great.
I have ambition. I just don't have a way to find out.
Why do I have so much stuff and yet nothing? Ponder that.
Why do I have so much stuff and yet nothing? The Joseph Devon story.
I've got flints and
the story of man.
And their junk. This goes in this chest. I'm not losing that. I've got three flints and tinders. You can go here. Signs. I guess I'll put those somewhere. Two blocks of dirt. I've got two. Does anyone need a bow?
You have the DVD of Signs directed by M. Night Shyamalan?
Shyamalan. Does anyone need a power two bow? Is anyone bowless?
No, I have a bow.
I do not. What do I have? I have a power one bow that's about dead.
I will bring this bow to you.
I'm way at the end of the bridge. If you want to leave it in one of the chests, that's cool.
I'm in the schoolhouse. You won't look in the chest for it.
I will. Probably. Maybe.
What if I do this?
Yay! Are you teleported to me?
What the freaking...
Dude. What happened?
Yeah, you've never seen those before?
I have not. What are these?
We had to make those end crystals because the end went crazy last night, and we made a bunch of them legitimately, and so now I just had extras.
That's awesome. Wow.
That takes gas tears and like an ender, or eye of ender, and all sorts of things.
That's crazy. Nice, good stuff.
Yeah.
Did you guys get those taiga, or not taiga, I'm sorry, that's a type of biome, the special wing things?
No, we weren't able to get there because, like, our end is glitched.
Oh, completely? Like, we don't have an end?
We have an end, we just can't get to that because after you kill the Ender Dragon, you're supposed to get a teleporter that lets you get over to that area, and we don't. So now we have to build, like, a 600-block-long thing because their city covers the entirety of the end in a giant circle on the outside.
Okay. For those of you who aren't aware, by the way, we had Richie on our stream last night, the Minecraft handoff stream, and him and Tony, because we had an extra person, the last hour, basically, the build was done, so him and Tony went looking for glider wings, is what they're called? Something like that?
From the
Elytra.
Yes. Something cool.
But yes, they're basically personal hang gliding wings.
And apparently they had some problems. I didn't get to watch that part of the stream. I was watching Ghostbusters.
Yes. So the end.
I am finishing the wall at the very top stair. Like, so.
I hit the photo booth up.
Yeah, this is actually kind of crazy.
Did you wipe the end?
We have not wiped the end yet.
Do we have to scrub it?
I mean, you really should probably scrub your end. Can...
You scrub your end and I'll scrub my end. Alright?
Is it like stuff clogging up the end? Is that the...
Pretty much. Like, it's just really a mess back there.
Is there anything in the end that, I mean, we don't have any builds over there or anything, right? So it won't...
No, we haven't built anything. We will have to kill the Ender Dragon again,
We're
though,
not
so that'll
cool
be fun.
Like Richie, where he has that giant Enderman farm. Where he just goes in, he swipes 3 times with his sword, and he's like, all right, well, I have 800
That's
experience.
That's crazy.
It's not fair.
Yeah, wow. Look, there. Uh-oh.
Wow. Joe felt that one coming from a ways away.
Also,
I thought he was talking about something in Minecraft, but no.
Nope.
He was about to be attacked.
I'm seeing Tony fill in the blocks, but he's too far away to see. Or Tony's invincible. Invisible. Something.
Both are very, very likely. I had to do that like 3 times yesterday.
Yeah. Tony, I'm going to go out on a limb and say maybe your CPU is starting to have some problems.
I don't think it's the CPU. I think it's honestly like a server issue that's been happening since 1.8.
Everything else is going wrong with your computer, though, too.
I mean,
like,
it
OBS
only had...
won't save your settings. Like, it's a very basic function of the program, and for some reason it doesn't work for you.
I know. It doesn't matter if it's a scene or a profile or other crap. It's just like, oh, we're going to make it so that you're always set to stream.
It really wants you to stream. Maybe we should listen. Maybe it's trying to tell us something.
Yeah.
Maybe you boy.
I was Hold watching on. A streamer that literally does 8 hours a day, 6 days a week.
Yeah?
Like, that is straight up just turning streaming into a full-time, like, all-out job. Like, I could do maybe, like, 2 or 3 hours a day. I could not do 8 hours straight of streaming.
Or eight hours straight? I assume he has a lunch break.
Oh. He had
that makes it easy.
8 hours straight.
Oh, did he? Really?
Yeah.
Plus, you can get up. I'm sure they probably like commercial breaks and stuff that he puts on to get up and stretch his
I'm
legs.
Sure. It was just like a crazy thought to me of like putting in 48 hours a week on streams.
Snow!
Any good?
Rain. He didn't talk for about 7 minutes.
What are we...
That we seems didn't... to be something people like. I think people on Twitch don't like the talking. I should try doing a Twitch stream where I just stay completely silent.
Right. I'll take money on that and how long that lasts. I don't think the silent game is your best best gambit there, Al.
You know, like, I have a hard time seeing you being able to like sit through a church sermon without being able to say like a bunch of stuff.
What is church like? You must be fairly... Well, maybe you're fascinated. I don't know. I don't want to.
I'm frequently fascinated. Our pastor says very intelligent things and unpacks some really cool stuff that sometimes I hadn't thought of before.
That's fair.
I'm just saying it's hard for me to.
I could see you just being bored as all hell. And
yeah,
I have been bored, completely bored in church, but not usually by him.
Yes, there's the other guest speaker.
I'm like. Well, I like the singing. The singing's fun.
Yeah, that's right. You would like the singing. Wow.
The entire reason I quit church, the singing.
Just the
I learned a lot
boredom.
About like
that
unpacking
not believing it,
sort
but,
of
you know.
You know, the deeper meanings of things in stories and whatnot from church.
I guess
the fine attention to detail in the scripture can be applied to other things as well, like Moby Dick or whatnot.
I was gonna say you're taking lessons from the Bible and applying them elsewhere? I don't think that's kind of revolutionary for a religion, isn't it?
I'm just bummed out. It is July the 15th when we're recording this, and I have not watched one single minute of Stranger Things yet.
I know, I have, like, I pinned, like, 3 things reminding myself to watch it tonight.
I told my wife, I was like, we could start watching this and, like, spend a lot of time watching it tomorrow and binge through the whole thing, but then I thought... Yeah, that's not going to happen. Our 1-year-old and our now 4-year-old are not going to allow us to do that. So
I don't know what this is. I should probably jump in now.
Stranger Things is a new show on Netflix. It's sort of kind of looks like E.T. meets What would it be? Some kind of a government... I mean, it's a government... looks like some kind of government conspiracy thing in a small town. I don't know if it's set in the 1980s, but it kind of has that very Spielbergian feel in the trailers. How would I describe this, Tony? Help me out. There's, like, shots of, like, kids in, like, weird plastic bubbles, and the mom's look... like, one kid disappears, and the mom's looking for him, and the other kids are looking for him. It's like an episode
one.
Make it
sound like a Code Adamant, like a Kmart.
Yeah, but, like, with aliens, or potentially government experiments.
What,
like,
about a Kmart? What?
Also, Code Adam is... oh, no, I guess that would be Universal. Code Adam... we did Code Adams at Walmart as well.
What?
Code Adam. We did it at Walmart as well. It's not just Kmart.
I don't know what a Code Adam is.
You're not supposed to talk about it, because then the pedophile knows that you're looking for him if you say it's a Code Adam.
Is this a Pokemon?
No, but I got my Boltaron or whatever it is.
And I got some good stuff.
Boltaron?
Hey.
Something like that.
Balls on head. Central Park is great for catching them. It is also terrible for service. So it's this horrible... ugh, just
are there
like
people just walking around with their phones up in the air, like doing that searching
absolutely
for signal thing?
Oh, that? I haven't seen so much. I think just people at this point are so used to... they're just like, well, it's dead. We'll give it 2 minutes to try it again, or we'll move on. Like, I don't think anyone... unless, like, there's like a... I don't even know what a super rare Pokemon is, but I'd imagine if there was one in the area, you would see a lot of people like, I can get signal back! I can get signal back!
I caught one of my first rares yesterday. Late night walk.
Does it tell you if it's rare?
I just looked at some charts, seeing how rare they were.
So usually I just look and see, is it grayed out? Okay, I'm interested. I get extra stuff for that.
Extra juice. I just catch them all. That's the slogan. I don't know if you're aware of that.
You, like, you've just got like 75
alone
rats.
Yes, I have so many. Well, I don't anymore. I grind them up for candy, but at various after various walks, I come home and there's just a lot of rats in my phone. I sort of wanted to go into this bit in the bonus podcast, but I didn't get to. I just enjoy the whole how just utterly cruel we are to Pokemon. Like, if you're lucky, you get to live in this tiny ball and fight when I tell you to. If not, it's off to the professor for candy, which just sounds terrible. No, like, nothing actually bad is mentioned in that phrase, but I can't say I send them off to the professor for candy and think that that's a good ending for them.
Yeah.
It just doesn't... it's a Code Adam, if you know what I mean. Which I'm assuming it's something about a pedophile? Would that be,
it means
that
a
you
kid
would...
has gone missing, basically, or a kid has been abducted.
Yeah, like you didn't want to say. We never lost anybody either, which was always annoyed by. I found the kid. Like it was a drop everything and go look for this kid. So no matter what you were doing, they call a Code Adam. These look cool, by the way. I know Joseph already mentioned it, but now seeing them. So everybody would have to go look at them, and it was like they were never close to my area. We would start sweeping the store immediately, and somebody else would find him. It's the highlight of your day. It's like, oh man, what if somebody snatched that kid? They never snatched him. The kid was always just like over there in the t-shirts. Yeah.
What is happening? What? Why?
Oh wow, there's a...
lag spike.
What?
Zombie.
Lag spike while I'm fighting two skeletons. This
where
is bad.
You? Are you on the block? No.
I'm on the block.
Are you in the lower block?
Did you
which district
because
are
that
you
skeleton
in?
Just died.
Oh boy.
And I can't move. What is happening?
Where are you?
Will this dog
I'm
get these zombies
over by
for
the
me?
Towers.
Oh, I know where you're
dogs can usually you, get nope. zombies.
Why
if it's
you
your dog.
It's not my dog. That's
it's
why
my
I asked.
Dog.
My
he's
dog.
He's gonna sit
where
there
he?
And let them... he's on the dirt block where you left him 2 weeks ago. The last month.
He's like
sitting
a Pokemon.
Here.
There he is. Hello. Hello.
Did the Pokemon move, by the way? How does that... how does that work? Do the Pokemon move?
Do they move?
Yeah.
And what? What do you mean? I don't understand the question. And I'm being serious. You see them like animate. Is that what you?
No.
Yeah, like whenever you
okay,
put them in fights, they'll be like biting and stuff.
No. When you're trying to find them.
Oh, I found an Eevee like a half
that
block away
sure.
from me like 12 times.
If I'm sitting there and being like, you know, oh, here's a Bulbasaur or something. And then I just sit there in the same place and watch him. Will he eventually move away?
I think
not really.
It's a
I think
static...
they more despawn.
Yeah, I think they spawn in one spot. Because I've had people tell me, hey, there's a blah 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 over there, and then gone over and found the blah blah blah.
The thing doesn't go away when they catch it?
No, it's not that.
Multiple people can catch the same one.
Yes, but I think the rare ones are just limited in, much more limited in time. I imagine it's a giant cycling, timer.
Okay.
However, initially I figured, oh, it's based off of me. You know, after I walk a few steps, it spawns, you know, things around where I am. But that doesn't make sense for the reasons I just said, because people can triangulate
well, if
in
you have
them.
An incense, like,
yeah,
then
also
it is
you can
based
use your
here.
Tracking thing. Have you looked at the tracking, Joe?
Yeah, yes.
Okay. Well,
which
you can, like,
any-
have
none
that
of the buttons do
open.
Anything, let's be honest.
And watch
I mean, like, for the actual program, I figured it was based on me, and it would count how many, how, give me, it would, after a certain amount of distance, it would randomly spawn a Pokemon, but it's, they're all there for everyone, so it's not based on my phone, it's...
It is program, if you have incense on you.
Yes, that's possible.
This week on the Pokemon block...
It's better than Tony's gnarled foot block, or whatever the podcast was a couple weeks ago.
My foot's still, like, slightly purplish,
and
but I keep walking on it.
And my balls are still swampy.
But hey, you know what? Hamilton musical. Tony wants to talk about his injured foot a bit. I think he's allowed a little, little leeway.
Ah! Burn. Get away from
all
me.
All I can think of is Blaircraft girls. What the hell is wrong with
Blaircraft?
My brain? I don't even know what that is. What?
It's the name of your new series, available on Hulu.
I think I'm having a stroke. I can't think of words. Not witchcraft girls. Gilmore girls. Thank you. That was way too difficult.
Might as well be witchcraft girls.
I guess. That sounds like it would be sort of...
That sounds like something that Lorelai would say, Tony.
Don't know who Lorelai is? Don't give a fuck. That
Dude,
reminds
she's
me,
one
I was actually told
girls.
To fuck off by a Pokemon trainer the other day because I was on Team Red.
Oh, really?
Yeah, this, like, probably 20-year-old kid was just basically like, you need to get the fuck out of my park, Red.
Wow, that's...
What the...
And I was
hey,
like, yeah.
I'm fine. I took
chest.
No damage from that.
The chest.
Oh, yeah, I forgot to tell you that those, these two things up here, extremely explosive. Do not punch them.
I didn't touch anything!
Why would you not mention that?
I forgot.
How did...
Oh my God.
That doesn't make any sense. How did we get... What happened?
You got creepered.
How did I not get hurt?
I think it hit the chest.
Because you're wearing armor.
I my armor didn't get hurt either. I'm not... I mean, I'm wearing diamond armor. It's pretty good armor, but...
I think you got behind... I think you, like, jumped over here, and the blast didn't... I don't really know. Whoa,
I'm
I don't
looking...
Want to pick
okay, there's
up.
That bow power, too, I was looking for.
Well,
I'm good.
What's this crap behind you?
I don't know. It's not my stuff.
Oh, boy. All right. I'll make some checks.
It was one of those dump boxes. Like, I need to carry more dirt.
No reason.
So if I walk into those things, they explode? Or if I
no,
punch
if
them?
No, if you punch them or shoot an arrow or glance at them just a little bit wrong, they might explode.
This is so
explode
Archer.
As in go away or like let off
as
an explosion?
As in probably blow up the bridge despite it being obsidian.
But it's but we have them as decoration.
Maybe we should put glass around them?
Or
although
anything,
I'm afraid to do that
a
now.
Sign? Something? By the way, this goes off for like no reason.
Oh, so many skeletons. You guys fight each other.
Oh, yeah. Hot skeleton on skeleton.
We got bone
action.
On bone crime.
Yeah. Do I have infinity? I don't have infinity. I need those arrows, sir. Oh, God. Just... I can't. Stuff keeps coming in while I'm. Okay. It's okay.
That would really suck. You're just like laying there and there's like three arrows in your belly, and the guy comes up and he's like, I need those back.
I'm sure they did that.
I know. That's what I'm thinking. Like, you just... They're barbed and everything. It's just
Tony's
like...
Back in arrow times.
Al, what did you do?
I mean, what did I do?
Oh, my God.
I don't know what you're even asking me.
This whole kerfuffle over here that's apparently not your problem. Well, there's another magical
yellow
bow.
Sheep. I'm going to tie you at the top of the dirt block if you don't move. There you go.
I'm coming
English.
At you, skeleton.
Here's some ham.
Got a shield. Ham for ham?
I don't... Oh, maybe the... It's like I'm trying to... It's like a bomb reconstruction. I'm trying to figure out where the chests were.
Hi, Joe.
That was great.
Yeah, don't fall off those either. They might explode.
Well, okay.
Actually,
thanks for that.
That's my favorite. That's my favorite. Oh, by the way, I forgot to mention, if you like, touch those things, they'll explode.
You're much akin to the that character in the Ghostbusters movie whose name I've forgotten. Kate McKinnon. Yeah.
That. Yes.
I mean, they look cool enough that I think it's worth the risk.
That's exactly what she would have said.
Are we still talking about Gilmore Girls or what's going on?
No, Ghostbusters.
Okay.
We've moved on to the other thing.
We're talking about Kate McKinnon's character. She's weird because she's like the most... She's the most definable character in that movie, and yet she is also simultaneously the least well-defined character. Like, she's just the manic pixie...
That was Kristen Wiig.
Kristen Wiig? I'm sorry.
Wiig.
Wait,
whatever.
No. Who? Isn't one of them called someone?
Kate yes. McKinnon is in the movie.
Yes.
Who is the one who plays the, like, blonde, manic...
The blue one?
Junker. What?
The blue one?
The blue one?
Bill Murray?
I don't know what you're talking about.
The guy with the blue face.
Oh.
Lee Pace?
They're making a callback. I get it now. Oh, he's a skeleton. There's
Kristen Wiig is the mousy one.
Oh, not her then.
Who
sorry.
Learns to trust in herself by the end of the movie, I'm
I only know
guessing.
Melissa McCarthy, because she's in Gilmore Girls.
Is she?
Yeah. Play
Please
Suki.
Don't.
Who the hell is Suki? There's no Suki in Gilmore Girls.
Yeah, there's Suki Stackhouse in, like, True Blood.
And there's a Suki in Gilmore Girls. Don't
I
argue
don't
with
believe
me.
That.
I watch this show every day.
I don't believe either of those things. I don't think that's possible.
That I could watch Gilmore Girls every day? I mean, sometimes I'll watch two episodes in a day, and then like the next day I'll be like, you know...
It averages out.
I could watch something else.
You've paid homage to the girls enough for the day.
Right. Or I just
Why
make
is
some
it
dark...
so deadly?
It's real bad. Somebody turned up the spawn counters to 11.
It's because it rained all day, so we didn't have a mob clearing sunrise.
It's really bad.
Someone turned the mob box up to 800.
I already made that reference.
I know, but it's a good reference. I can't stop laughing about it.
It had a shield. I wonder if it's down underneath the stairs still.
Also, real quick, I guess maybe this won't be captured forever. Albert, can you explain what you did in Dwarf Fortress Adventure Mode today?
Oh, so somebody suggested that we should make a... Because one of the things you can do is you can perform in Dwarf Fortress. You can do dances, you can, I think, recite poetry, and one of the things is you can do... you can sing songs.
No. Okay.
God, it is deadly.
That wasn't as bad.
So I made a performer. The first one I made was a dwarf, which yes. is always a hazard, because sometimes you end up in dwarf land and they're just forever underground.
Yes.
I managed to find the roads, because you can do the same fast travel thing with dwarves as you can with
Useless,
humans.
Useless, though. You're still just stuck under... That's not... Yeah.
They have, like, these just endless underground roads, and they don't go anywhere except for, like, dwarf farms and annoying places like that. But, after I gave up on that, I made a cockroach man. And I gave him really good musicality skill, and, went around...
To
people's
band.
Houses. And I kept asking them, like, hey, do you want to go out performing with me? Because that's an option you can do. You can, like, ask people to... Just like you can ask people to go on a quest with you to fight, you can ask them to be in your band.
I envision this giant... He's got, like, a hat on. He's like, hello.
So I'm going into people's houses. Oh, these guys are fighting each other. Good. And, I'm going into people's houses that did not invite me.
breaking into people's houses. Let's
well,
just...
I mean, the door is open. It's not like they're... I'm not picking the lock or anything. They're just in there sort of chilling. I imagine they don't have a lot going on. And this giant cockroach man walks in and he's like, what's up? Want to be in my band? And they say to me, like, well, I don't know anything about your skill level. I need to hear a sample of your work.
What the fuck are you?
So you record... Not record. You, like, you perform for them. And one of the options, so you get to pick your song, which the titles of the songs are hilarious. There's one that's just called Torture. I was imagining myself in a heavy metal band. So that was a lot of fun. But I got, you know, you would start to play, and there's the two options of you can either be the singer, you can do the chanting, or you can do the instrumental part, but the instrument, you don't have the instrument, so you have to imitate the instrument sounds with your mouth. And they sing along with you. And it, like, as you go along, it tells you how you're doing, so it, like, it has this thing where you're like, you know, the person will be singing with you, and they'll say, you know, oh, so-and-so's doing a really good job singing, and then, like, you did a really poor job imitating the bagpipes or whatever. They're not bagpipes, but they're unique instruments for Dwarf Fortress, and it goes on like that. It's, and then eventually, like, you get to the end, and because you're a giant cockroach person, they won't go with you. They're like, yeah, I'd rather not.
Put your fingers in. Oh, God. You're like, well, I don't know, how talented are you? And you're like, dig this. Like, you're just like, it's like me playing air guitar and singing along to things. I'm just like, wow, this guy's good. And it's this giant cockroach doing this.
Oh, I wish that could be an animation.
Well, I did record that stream, actually. So I might put up a greatest hits of it, because some of it was kind of boring, like that part where I was lost underneath underground. I'm just like, where am I? Why can't I get out? I assume that I lost some viewers for that part. I was just like, eventually found something to kill me.
Or could you use suicide in that game?
What?
Could you suicide to start over?
I think you can't. You can just give in to starvation. You can just, or you can just retire at a, like, you can. I have a squirrel girl character that has went into goblin territory, and she was actually not doing too bad, but because there were so many characters on screen, the computer bogs down and like will render like one movement every 5 seconds.
FPS.
And that also is not great for a screen, for a stream. So I saved out for her, and it just says retire at that location, but.
Oh, no.
You know, I could go back to her if I could play. I could select play as a specific person, and if I wanted to, I could go back to her.
Except, every new person you do moves forward 2 weeks, and she might be dead in Goblin Land.
Dead.
Or maybe she's moved out.
Al, don't stop. You're gonna back into it.
What the heck is that?
I was trying to scare you by having you turn around and see it, not have you back straight into lava.
Since when do I burn out as I'm laying dirt?
King of pranksters.
You know what? I appreciate you warning me.
You were going to straight up back into that lava. I wanted to startle you, not make you lose diamond gear. I should have just let it happen.
If you're going to do the bit, you should commit to the bit, Tony. I hate to say that. I would have yelled at you if you did say it, but... I'm now, like, if you back off, you're like, well, I didn't want to.
I wanted to startle you. Like, I wanted to, but I didn't want to.
I understand. I appreciate the sentiment.
There was genuine panic in your voice. You really didn't want to actually have him burn up and die. I just like that your prank was putting down lava, which is...
It's like, ha ha, a little funny lava.
Wait, yeah.
Wait, he's still coming. Wait, why is he stopping? I'm looking down, looking for Pokemon on my phone.
Another damn Pidgey.
There's an Abra somewhere around here.
A what?
Abra.
I think I have one of those.
Followed by Kadabra.
Yep.
Abra, Abracadabra. Wonk, wonk, I wanna reach out and grab you. Oh, Cars? No? Alright.
What? That's not in Cars.
That's not the Cars, is it?
Cars is Life is a Highway.
No. Just no.
Oh, Rascal Flatts.
No.
All night long.
No. Is that yeah, that's the Cars. Yeah.
I think he's talking about sex.
What? The song or me?
The song.
Life is a Highway?
Driving the highway all night long.
Well, he lists actual places. Guy whose name I still don't know. But I know enough to know I don't know it at this point. Rich?
It's Rascal Flatts.
Sure. Yes, him.
Let's think it in the
that's
car.
That's a cover, though, isn't it?
Yes, it is. But it's better than the original. I can't remember who did the
original. What was it in Cars? That hack Bruce Springsteen.
What do you mean, what was it in Cars?
Was the original in Cars?
No, the original is not in Cars. The cover's in Cars.
Who covered it?
Rascal Flatts covered it.
Oh, who's the original?
I don't know.
I think Tony cut out there.
I don't care about the original. I like the one in Cars.
Third base.
Woo! Got them relevant pop culture references.
Yep.
Reaching all the way back to
always relevant. In my
Who did I use? I can't get organized with. Man, that's something nobody. I was gonna say I'll give something to somebody who tweets in and tells me what that means, but I don't have anything to give away. So,
could somebody come punch this tree?
I can't get organized.
I'm stuck.
Where?
Greatest comedy duo of all time.
Mothers Brothers.
No.
Abbott and Costello.
No.
It's some.
Roland Hardy.
Oh, I don't know too much of their stuff. Tony, where are you?
I got out. I had to just punch leaves for a while.
Brothers are great. They're very underrated. I will argue that people who haven't heard of them should definitely check them out, but they are not Abbott and Costello. I mean, Laurel and Hardy. Abbott and Costello can just, like, jump into a fire.
Strong feelings for Mr. Berg on Abbott and Costello.
Yeah.
They're not funny. Well, I mean, okay, who's on first?
What are you talking? What? Good Lord.
Have you sit through Abbott and Costello Meet the Wolf Man? Okay, it's not good.
No, I won't.
I'm not doing that one for Universal Monsters Month this year.
I don't think we're bringing back Universal Monsters Month.
Why not? There's like 800 other movies.
Halloween should be a signature month. That was almost English.
October
should be some sort of theme month, I think.
You don't realize how many Universal movies there were. Like, people are talking about this new Universal Monsters shared universe, like it's a new thing. Like, Universal did the Monsters shared universe before anybody else ever thought of a shared universe.
Except for, like, way back in the day when it literally was Monsters in the Universe.
That's not, I mean, fictional, like, crafted to be...
Like, when people believed in the devil, I think that all the stories about the devil took place in the same universe.
Well, yeah, but even then, you probably have inconsistencies, like, oh, well, my devil doesn't, you know, shapeshift.
Mine claims his first name is Beelzebub.
It's the devil, though. I mean, he's gonna do shit like that. Gonna keep you on your toes.
I've been reading Swamp Thing lately.
Swamp Thing.
But I don't have time to talk about it, because that's the end of the dirt block.
Yay! No,
thanks for listening, everybody.
Stuck?
No, it's okay, Tony, it is.
No.
We'll do more.
All right.
We'll do another one next week, and maybe I'll talk about Swamp Thing then.
Yay!